Namaskar. I am Nitin Amin and I have Nandu Kulkarni with me.
Namaskar.
Nandu has given me a task: explain a rag in 5 minutes. Now that's a big ask. So we decided to give it a try. So where do you want to begin, Nandu?
So Nitin, how about starting with Marubihag?
Oh, why Marubihag?
See, I heard this Kishore Kumar song on Vivid Bharati this morning, Payala Wali Dekhna.
Yeah.
And since it is in Marubihag, why don't we start with Marubihag?
So you know that the song is in Marubihag.
Huh.
And probably, you know, this is the best way to identify a rag. Associate the melodic phrases, because rag is nothing but a collection of melodic phrases. And a song also is a melody. So all you need to be able to is to identify these small phrases.
Right.
So let's do one thing. Do you know any other songs in Marubihag?
Yeah, there are a couple of other songs. There is a Lata Mangeshkar song from Sehra.
Mm-hmm. Tum Toh Pyar Ho.
Tum Toh Pyar Ho.
Yes.
And the third one that I know is a Mukesh song.
Mm-hmm.
Matwali Naar Thumaka Thumaka Chali Jai.
Oh yeah.
Right.
So let's, you know, listen to all these songs one after the other and then take it on from there.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so these were the three songs.
Right.
Now what happens normally is these songs, you never listen to them one after the other. You are listening to these songs at different, you know, different events,
different times.
And they are in different keys, you know. So right. There's a song in a female key, there's a song in a male key. And so it becomes a bit more difficult to start associating with the melodic phrases. So the best way again is if I can play all these three songs one after the other on my flute, then you will notice that it is the same melody that is repeating. So let's
Sounds like a good idea.
Okay. Yeah, let's try doing that. Yeah, so we began with, next one was, this was Payal Wali.
Right.
Start seeing the similarity in the phrases, and
right.
Then you realize that probably this seems to be the common phrase. So
yeah.
this is probably the defining phrase of Marubihag. So the way Marubihag goes is, so this is the beginning of Marubihag. Then you go on. Comes the very characteristic. So you will see this phrase coming. Anytime anybody sings or plays Marubihag, these phrases would keep coming. So song exactly is the same.
Yeah.
Now, we don't really want to get into the grammar of the rag, but I think it's important to know some notes, you know, some specific notes. And every time we take up a rag, you know, we will touch upon some of those notes. So it is important to know that there are two kinds of the mas. So this is one ma. Sagama ma pa. This is one version of the ma, and the other version is. Samama gama ma pa. So these two versions of the madhyam are the ma, ma of the saregama. So the ma, they play a very vital role in defining the characteristic of the. And that is precisely what is happening in Marubihag. You know, the Tivra Madhyam, that is the takes on a very prominent position. And the other version of the Ma, the Shuddha Ma, comes only in that very characteristic way, you know. So this is Marubihag.
Right.
If you remember, you know, in the 70s, I think it was the Prabhatri's Jago Mein Saari Rehna.
Correct. So Nitin, why don't you play Bandesh in Marubihag on your flute?
I'll do that, yeah. Yes.
Is there anything common between Bihag and Marubihag apart from the Bihag in the name?
Bihag in the name, and they share exactly the same set of notes.
Okay.
But they are very, very different.
Right.
So why don't we take up Bihag next time?
Okay. Sounds like a good idea.
Yeah.